Hello everyone, it's Marina from Say Something Crafty. I'm here to do a share with you. These are images from my my vintage book, Stepping Stones to Happiness. Oops. So this is the book that I got the images from. This book is, I wrote this down because I keep forgetting. This book is from 1897, so it's 121 years old, and I have images in it that were just super beautiful that I've been using in journals, and I've had quite a few people ask me if I was able to share these images, and I am. I found a way to share them, so I was super excited. I also took out images from Europe Illustrated, which is from 1888. This book was super old. It's in really good condition, and I managed to copy all of those as well into my computer. And so this Europe Illustrated is 130 years old. So it's pretty. They're both pretty old, and I really loved the images in them, and I managed to save them, which I'm really glad because I've never done anything like this before. But they have all these really gorgeous images, and I really wanted to use them and share with you also, because if I only use them once, then I can't use them again, and it was what was making me not want to use them. But I found out if a book is before 1923, you're not going to have any copyright issues, because that was before the copyright laws started happening. So I have all these images that I cut out. These are the singular images. I made kits. I made kits, you guys. They're like I would have uploaded more than 5 per download, but Etsy has a limit of 5 files, and they're PDF files, and I did them in a way where there's separate images, and then there's ones that are like this, so that way you can fold them and turn them into put them in your journal. So I did my best to make sure that these were done in a way that they still have some of the images, they still have some of the poems on them, and stuff like that. These are such gorgeous images. I love them so much. I love this one with the mother and father and their sleeping children, and then the children here reading together. I love that so much. So I'm super excited to share these with you guys. These are just some that I coffee dyed earlier and made for this book. So I just wanted to give you guys a couple of examples, or I guess I have some ideas of the way that you can use these. So these are all the originals here. I have a bunch of them. They took this. I've never done anything like this. I did not expect it to be so, you gotta do a lot. So these images are fantastic. They came out good. I'm really happy with them. And I just wanted to share them with you guys and share with you the journal that I made. So these, all of these here, all of these pictures and pages will be in my Etsy shop, and you can download them. Move this here. And I also wanted to tell you that before I get started with this one, that I did go ahead and take these out and cut them down in case you guys were interested in these. I didn't know if you'd be interested in these, but I wanted to ask your opinion because I don't know what you guys would like. So, I mean, I had a couple of requests, but I had a lot of requests for those because I didn't really go into depth on this one too much. But there's a lot, because this is Europe Illustrated, so it's got Spain, it's got Germany, Old Britain, it's got, the French, it had France in there, but I put the France in a different book before I started scanning them in. So this one is one of my favorite images. And this one is the some of the old rooms in Spain, or I don't know how to explain it. They have peacocks in them. So pretty. So yeah, there's a lot of different pictures of places in here. I'm not gonna, you know, go through every single one, but these are just, to me, they're really, really gorgeous. I love these. I love the way they did the art in these books, and I felt so bad cutting it up, but I'm actually really happy I did, because I scanned them in so I can use them and others can use them, and they can have them forever. It's better than it just sitting on the shelf and not being used. So thank you so much for telling me that. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get started on this journal that I made. This is just made with a, I believe it's 12 by, I hit my ruler, 12 by 6. So this is just a 12 by 6 journal that I made with some extra, this is vintage laces here, and this one is actually vintage too, and it's just got elastic, it's pretty cool. I got these from Sherry, and I got this in a swap. I love this back here, it's so pretty. So I also got this coin trim from Kimmy. Thank you so much, Kimmy. And I also have some book corner, not book corners, but I have some corners on this book. So I'm just gonna go inside, and that way I can show you guys what I did with this and how I implemented these into here. I'll also have a link below for the two journals that I made using these larger pages, so you guys can see these as well. Let me know if you're interested in, if you would like me to scan these into the computer. I just didn't want to do all of that if you guys weren't interested in it. So let me know, and I will definitely add these pages into my Etsy shop as well. So here I have, this is from the book. I copied that, I copy dyed it, and then I have a label up here that says this book belongs to. And here's one of the other images. Isn't this so pretty? I love this so much. As a mom, I think I just love all the children and parent images. And then I stamp this. Oh yeah, before I go into this too much further, I also will be having a full length, not a full length, I'm gonna speed it up, of course, but it's gonna be everything I did making this journal. So you guys will be watching me make this journal. If you're interested, you can stay tuned after the flip through and you can watch me make the whole thing. So that's just a little extra that I wanted to add onto the video for you guys. So here, I stamped the birth date. It says Uniquely Handmade Limited Edition, and I did get this stamp from Irene. I love this stamp. Thank you, Irene. And then, I signed it, and then I stamped the birth date of the book in here. And then that just goes in there. So I'm going to flip through the pages. I love this blue. It's so pretty. This is one of the images from the book. So beautiful. I love that. I have another one that I put here from the cutouts and the extra images. I put another one in here, just a side pocket. I've added some more here, and then this one dyed really dark, but I still like it. I like how grungy it looks. Looks old. Then there's just some more Tim Holtz ephemera in here. Freya, don't climb on the sewing machine. And then this is clipped in here. It's just a tag that I made. And then there's some washi tape there. And here's the other side of that page. What? What are you meowing for? You get to explore. You should be happy. You're okay. Okay, and then I have this image right here, this pocket right here, this envelope that I altered, and you'll see I did a whole video. Sorry, guys, I'm tired, but I'm trying to get this video done. I have a, in the video, you see how I put this whole pocket together. And I glued this tag down, turned that into a pocket, and then it's just got two little pieces of ephemera inside. I really like this. I think I'm going to do this on one of my envelopes. And then this is one of my favorite images here. I love this too. So cute. Guys, I put most of my favorite ones in here because I'm going to say this is my favorite a lot. This is my favorite too. When I was growing up, I loved my dad. I would say I was more of a daddy's girl than a mommy's girl, but I wasn't around my dad too much, but I liked the time that I did get to spend with him, and it really meant a lot to me. So I love the fact that my daughter and it just, the relationship between my husband and my daughter is just, I love it. So I'm just sorry that I didn't give her a sister. So here's another pocket that I made, and this is also the other side of the coffee dyed paper bag. And I just have some more extra pieces in here. That just tucks in there. And then inside of the bag is another image. I like how this coffee dye looks so pretty. And then towards the back, there's this really, really beautiful image of a few kids at the beach. So cute. Are you gonna come up here, Freya? And then I just have some stuff tucked back here, and I did a double pocket. So there's a pocket here and then one right here. And I just put a little tag in there. And then here's another one of the images from the collection. And that's the back. So that is this journal. I hope you guys enjoyed the flip through. I really had a lot of fun doing this because this is something I haven't done before, and I was really actually scared. I was really scared to do it because I didn't have any idea what I was doing. And so hopefully this turned out good, and I hope you guys will take some time and take a look at the images that I have available for you, because there's a ton of them, you guys. There's so many. Love these. So let me know if you have any questions. And I will see you guys next time. Oh yeah, so I will have a link below for the larger journals as well as my Etsy shop if you guys are interested in checking out any of these images. All right, I will see you guys next time. Bye.